Hello and welcome to another class of the Scriptcase Fundamentals training. In this class, I will be showing you the different types of charts available in Scriptcase. The quantity of metrics used in the chart application will define which charts are available to use. The types of charts available in Scriptcase are bar, column, line, area, pie, donut, pyramid, funnel, radar, scatter, bubble, stacked, and gorge. Let's check these available charts out on the Scriptcase website and the samples area where you will find each available chart. The bar chart. The bar chart displays a section of rectangular horizontal bars with a proportional length to the values it represents. It is used to illustrate comparison between values. The x-axis of the chart displays specifically what is being compared, while the y-axis represents discrete values. Some bar charts have grouped bars, and others display the bars stacked in subparts to show the cumulative effect. This feature is only available when the chart contains multiple fields selected in the y-axis. The column chart. The columns chart displays a section of vertical rectangular bars with proportional length to the values it represents. It is used to illustrate comparison between values. The y-axis of the chart displays specifically what is being compared, while the x-axis represents discrete values. Some column charts have grouped columns, and others display the columns stacked in subparts to show the cumulative effect. This feature is only available when the chart contains multiple x-axes. The line chart. The line chart displays a series as a set of points connected by a single line. Graph rows are used to represent large amounts of data that occur over a continuous period of time. The line graph consists of two axes, one vertical and one horizontal, and a line representing a timeline displaying information between a series of points called anchors, bound by a straight line, curve, or step segments. The area chart. The area chart displays a series as a set of points connected by a single line with the entire area below filled. The areas display time series stacked on the y-axis against equally spaced time intervals on the x-axis. The area chart is composed of two axes, one vertical and one horizontal, and an area representing the time series displaying information between a series of points called anchors bound by straight or curve area segments. The pie chart. The pie chart is a diagram in which the percentage or value of each pie sector represented is proportional to the respective measures of the angles. Pie charts and donut graphs display data as a proportion of the whole and are most commonly used to make comparisons between groups. They make up a group of graphs known as shape charts and have no axes. The pyramid chart. The pyramid chart displays the value data as percentages of the whole. They are commonly used to show proportional comparisons between different values in a set. Categories are represented by individual segments of the pyramid and have their size determined by value. The funnel chart. The funnel chart displays values as ratios that decrease progressively, depleting of the base value. The size of the area is determined by the value of the series as a percentage of the total of the difference of all the values sequentially. The radar chart. The radar chart displays a series as a set of points grouped by category in a 360-degree circle. Values are represented by the length of the point as measured from the center of the circle. The further the point is from the center, the greater its value. Category labels are displayed on the perimeter of the chart. The scatter chart. The scatter plot and rows are very similar. They are used to puncture data on a vertical and horizontal axis with the intention of displaying how much one variable is affected by another. Each row in the data table is represented by a marker whose position depends on its values in the column determined by the X and Y axes. The bubble chart, or points and bubbles. The scatter plot consists of two axes, one vertical and one horizontal, and a series of points called anchors which can be displayed as dots or bubbles. The maps chart. The map chart displays your presentation to a geographic map using location information, where the data in a column is displayed on the map according to the geographic location which the data is associated with. Geographic charts can display geographic information at various levels of accuracy, and locations with data are indicated by the marker color and shape. The gorge chart. The gorge graph has a circular or semicircular arc and displays values that track progress against a goal. The target or target value is represented by the pointer. The value representing progress is shown inside the arc. All possible values are evenly distributed along the arc from the minimum leftmost value to the maximum rightmost value. The combination chart. The combined chart allows you to display a primary series, such as columns or bars, and another secondary data series as a different marker type, such as a row or area. An important feature implemented in the charts is the trend line that follows the trend within the chart. Thank you for watching this part of the Scriptcase Fundamentals training. I hope to see you again soon in the next class.